Step 1, fold the paper strips. Step 2, weave the polyhedron. Tools used, 6 binder clips. Let's start by observing the structure of this small triangular hexacontahedron. In the weaving technique, it should be seen as replacing each face of a regular icosahedron with a triangular pyramid. Originally, each vertex of the regular icosahedron is shared by 5 triangles. After replacing them with triangular pyramids, each vertex is shared by 5 triangular pyramids. The weaving method begins by focusing on one vertex at a time. Start by weaving the 5 triangular pyramids around that vertex. Then, shift your focus to the other vertices, one by one, and weave the 5 triangular pyramids surrounding each vertex. First, you should be able to identify that each folded paper strip has a raised vertex at its center. Overlap the raised vertices of 3 paper strips, allowing them to cross each other. This forms the first triangular pyramid. Next, you may notice that next to this triangular pyramid, there appears to be another one, except it's missing one paper strip. So, add one more paper strip, positioning the raised vertex in the center of the vertex of the triangular pyramid. This creates the second triangular pyramid. To avoid any loose structure, hold and secure temporarily the paper strips that are not in use. Repeat the same process, adding one more paper strip next to the second triangular pyramid, creating the third triangular pyramid. Fold and secure temporarily the unused paper strips. Up to this point, we've woven together three adjacent triangular pyramids. These three can be seen as surrounding a common vertex, which currently lacks two triangular pyramids. You can see that two more triangular pyramids are partially formed next to these, but they are both missing one paper strip. So, weave these two sets of paper strips together to create the fourth and fifth triangular pyramids. Next, fix temporarily. Now, focus on another vertex. This vertex should also be surrounded by five triangular pyramids, but currently, there are only two. Repeat the process to add the third one. Simple fixing on the side. From the sides of these three adjacent triangular pyramids, weave the two sets of paper strips together to create the fourth and fifth triangular pyramids. The next vertex already has three triangular pyramids woven. Similarly, weave the two sets of paper strips on the side to create the fourth and fifth triangular pyramids. Repeat the previous method to complete the second layer of triangular pyramids. However, it's essential to note that each paper strip will form a loop around two rhombic faces after making a full round. Fix briefly on the side. At this point, the structure begins to resemble a sphere, and we are entering the finishing phase. Start by observing which area has more paper strips left and begin there. For instance, in this area, more paper strips remain, and this vertex needs to be surrounded by 5 triangular pyramids. Repeat the previous method to weave these 5 triangular pyramids. The principle remains the same for the following steps. Start with the area where more paper strips are left and complete the triangular pyramids adjacent to each vertex. However, it's important to note that each paper strip will overlap 2 rhombic faces and form a loop independently.